Good morning. So continuing with halachot of hadlakat nerot erev Shabbat. The halacha basically is that everybody individually has an obligation to see to it that the house is lit. However, not everybody has to light the candles. Everybody is yotzeh as long as one person lights the candles, typically the lady of the house, the mother, the wife. So she is motzi everybody with her hadlakat nerot. So although we all have the obligation to see to it that the house is illuminated, not everybody has to light the candles. It's enough for one person to light, and that discharges the obligation from everybody else as well. What does it take to qualify for her lighting? In other words, if she's going to light, who does she include? So anybody who's part of the household. So the question becomes, what is considered part of a household such that we're being included with the lady of the house's lighting? So certainly anyone who is a child, who lives in the home, even if they're over bar or bat mitzvah, minhag sfaradim is that the girls typically do not light candles. Anyone who is single and living in the house, they're included in the lighting of the mother. They're part of the household. When a person goes away, let's say to visit somewhere else, as long as you have a private room in that house, which is the typical situation, when a person goes visiting somewhere, so he goes away for Shabbat, he has a private room, then that room, to a certain degree, is your house. The host does not really have access to that room, and therefore the guest has to see to it that that room is illuminated. Now, are you going to light candles in that room? Sometimes there are safety issues that are a very real concern. So therefore, many people would prefer to light in the dining room. But this brings us, as we mentioned once before, this brings us to an important machloket, and we're not here to mention the halachot Ashkenazim, but we are here to clarify that even according to Ashkenazim, there is a certain way to do things that is considered more preferable. But basically, first things first, for Sfaradim. We hold that if the hostess has already lit candles in the dining room, then any additional nerot are really superfluous. They're extra, they're not necessary, and therefore you cannot make a bracha on them. So again, classic situation, children, daughters-in-law, daughters going home to their parents and on Friday night, so the mother-in-law, the mother is going to light candles. Really, any additional nerot are extra. And although the minhag of Ashkenazim is to allow people to make a bracha on those extra lights, that's not the minhag of Sfaradim. So, cutting to the chase, if a person is not comfortable, which makes sense, to light in their bedroom when they're a guest away from home, which is because of safety concerns, so then what the daughter or the daughter-in-law should do is she should light in the dining room, but without a bracha. So the halacha brura recommends that what the daughter or daughter-in-law should do is she should light, she should say the words of the bracha and only think in her head the Shem Shamayim. Ruch atam, and she thinks Hashem Elokeinu Melech Haolam. She could say out, La'adlik ner shel Shabbat. Hashem Kishem Tzav Tzvan La'adlik ner shel Shabbat. So she can sort of half make the bracha, but just having in mind the Shem Malchut. Why? Because she really cannot make brachot on that candle lighting since it's extra and superfluous according to our custom. In a hotel, for example, when people a lot of times also there's a policy at the hotel you cannot light in the room. You can't leave a flame unsupervised. A lot of times the hotel tries to accommodate people by saying, okay, everybody's going to light here on this table in the dining room. And you have hundreds of candles. According to even Ashkenazim, that is almost, according to everybody, prohibited to make a bracha on that light. Because it's completely useless. It doesn't add at all. The room is already well illuminated. And there's hundreds of candles there. Your candlelight is adding nothing. So in that case, a person should see to it, although they can't make a bracha in this fashion, they should see to it that the room in which they're staying, that they put on a light before Shabbat, I'm not talking about a candle, they turn on a light, even if it's a bathroom light, and they should have in mind that that is the light that they're lighting for the purposes of Shabbat. And that they will fulfill the mitzvah in that way. In both of these situations where the woman is lighting, but without a bracha, this counts as the mitzvah, and she does not have to add on a candle, which we'll talk about at a different time in coming weeks. There is a, so to speak, a knas, a penalty, that if a woman ever forgets, then for the rest of her life, she has to always add on one extra candle. In both of these cases, where she does light, but in this unusual fashion, it still counts as lighting, she does not have the penalty of having to add on a candle going forward.